gladly go to their deaths with the hope that they'll be accepted into the Legion of the Zombies, winning the favor of Baron Samedi, and this way, enjoy the privilege of the living death.
On our way to work one morning, down the path, along the lane, a tender-hearted woman saw a poor, half-frozen snake. His pretty colored skin had been all frosted with the dew. "Oh, well," she cried, "I'll take you in, like we're doing, and I'll take care of you. Take me, oh, tender woman, take me in, for heaven's sake. Take me in, oh, tender woman," sighed the broken snake. She wrapped him up all cozy in a curvature of silk, and then laid him by the fireside with some honey and some milk. Now she hurried home from work that night. As soon as she arrived, she found that pretty snake she'd taken in had been revived. "Take me in, oh tender woman. Take me in, for heaven's sake. Take me in, oh tender woman," sighed the broken snake. Now she clutched him to her bosom. "You're so beautiful," she cried, "but if I hadn't brought you in by now, you certainly might have died." Now she stroked his pretty skin, and then she kissed and held him tight. But instead of saying thank you, that snake gave her a vicious bite. "Take me in, oh tender woman, take me in. Take me in, oh tender woman," sighed the vicious snake. "I saved you, cried the woman, and you've bit me. Heavens, why? You know your bite is poisonous, and now I'm going to die." "Oh, shut up, silly woman," said the reptile with a grin. "You knew damn well I was a snake before you took me in."